Hey, it's ShadowACS again. This is a show about a delicious energy drink. Okay, I'm sorry, I know that pun was terrible, but it had to be made at some point. It was way too obvious. So I figured I'd just get it out of the way. Anyway, let's take a look at Monster. Monster is easily one of my biggest review requests to date. And after watching it, it's not difficult to see why. Not only is it one of the best anime I've ever seen, it's also one of the most adult. It's the only anime I've seen in a while that has nothing supernatural or sci-fi related in it, at all. In fact, I sort of wonder why it even needed to be an anime. It seems like they could have just as easily made it a live-action show. The story and tone are a lot closer to something like Breaking Bad than they are to most anime. But hey, all the better for me that it's an anime because I get to review it. Monster is probably the best psychological thriller anime I've seen aside from Death Note. And it's important to note that because there's no dazzling supernatural elements anywhere in the show, the story and the writing have to be good for it to work, since they're all the audience has to go off of. And both of those elements are done fantastically well. But don't take my word for it, let's take a look at it. I should probably mention first of all that Monster was one of the longest anime I've reviewed yet on this show, totaling in at 74 episodes. And because its story, even in the beginning, is based heavily around surprises, I have to be pretty vague when talking about what happens in it to avoid spoiling anything. The show is about a Japanese doctor living in Germany named Kenzo Tenma, who has a reputation for being one of the most brilliant neurosurgeons in the country. One day, a pair of twins named Johann and Anna Liebert are brought into the hospital shortly after their parents had just been murdered. The boy Johann has suffered a gunshot wound to the head, while Anna is traumatized and unable to speak. Dr. Tenma manages to save Johann's life, but a few days later, the twins mysteriously vanish from the hospital. Years go by, with Dr. Tenma still continuing a successful career in neurosurgery. Until one day when he finds out that the boy Johann has grown up to be a vicious serial killer, who even at the age of 20 has killed countless people and has a huge criminal network working under him. Horrified by what he's unleashed upon the world, Dr. Tenma makes a vow to track down Johann and end the life he never should have saved. This is a brilliant premise for a psychological thriller, for a number of reasons. Not only does it allow for a ton of great possibilities in character and suspense, but it also taps upon a subject that doesn't really see much attention in the media. The responsibilities of being a doctor, told from a doctor's perspective. Think about all the doctors you've seen in media. They're usually just background characters who show up briefly to take care of the main action hero when they get hurt or do something stupid. This is the first show I've seen where they really dive into the ethics and responsibilities that come with being a doctor, and the psychological toll they take on the doctor himself. In the beginning, Dr. Tenma's boss is what many people would consider to be a horrible person, who's concerned more for his hospital's publicity than he is for his patients' lives. To the point where when Johann is first brought in, he orders Dr. Tenma to operate on the mayor instead, because it'll do more for the hospital's reputation, essentially leaving Johann to die. But Dr. Tenma disobeys and saves Johann anyway because he believes, as a doctor ethically should, that all human lives are equal, even though it might cost him his career. So when Tenma finds out what a monster Johann's grown up to be, his entire reality is shattered. He's forced to confront the reality standing right in front of him that saving this one life resulted in the deaths of countless others. And it's this internal struggle that makes Dr. Tenma such a great main character. Even though he's out to take someone's life, you still understand the struggle he's going through and what's brought him there. I also love how despite what a terrible toll Tenma's journey takes, there's still this incredible kindness to him. He'll go out of his way to help any sick or injured person he comes across, even if they're a complete stranger. It doesn't matter if that person is a thief or a criminal, if he believes there's a chance they can be redeemed, then on his honor as a doctor, they're worth saving. The one exception, of course, being Johann. And speaking of which, let's talk about Johann. This was the character that everybody told me about before watching this anime, and by God, I can see why. I think Johann caps the list for best anime villain I've ever seen. Right down to the first scene where he confronts Tenma, which in my opinion is the best scene in the anime. It takes place in a dark warehouse with this great image of Johann's face completely in shadow. And Johann tells Tenma how grateful he is for saving his life just before shooting a patient of his right in front of him.
You cared for me and you restored me to life. So I feel as though you're like a father to me.
Like a father?
The truth is, if it weren't for you, I wouldn't be standing here right now.
One interesting thing I noticed about Johann is that he doesn't actually appear that often in the anime. Most of the story is spent with people trying to track him down and find him, but it's like chasing a ghost. He's always two steps ahead of Tenma and the others, and he'll sometimes even leave cryptic messages for the people he knows are looking for him. But when Johan does show up, you take in every inch of his presence. You listen to every word he says. I also noticed that Johan doesn't actually kill very many people on screen, at least not directly. He seems to be more about trying to convince other people to kill themselves and each other. He's very much a Hannibal Lecter-esque villain that way. And I think that's even more terrifying because it's like not even your thoughts are safe from him. He'll reach into your past and grab whatever dark threads he can find to make your sanity collapse in on itself. In fact, it's possible he even sent Dr. Tenma after him on purpose in this same way, knowing Tenma would destroy himself by fruitlessly chasing him around the country. There's one scene where Johan has all these people locked in a burning building, fighting to get out, and he's just standing there amongst the flames with this cold, unfeeling smile on his face. It's like something out of a nightmare. But Johan aside, another thing about Monster I need to bring up is the story, which like I said is really long, and there's a ton of different plot threads to keep track of. One thing I noticed is that every time a story arc ends, they usually start the next one by introducing a completely new set of characters, taking a few episodes for us to get to know them, what's going on with their lives, and eventually how their situation connects to the story about Johan and Tenma. In fact, there's quite a few episodes that go by without Johan or Dr. Tenma even being mentioned, because they're too busy focusing on all these new characters they keep creating. It's a very unique way of telling a story, and for the most part, it's pretty effective. Although it does tie into the one criticism a lot of people seem to have with Monster, that it is pretty slow at times. And I can definitely see where this opinion comes from. Every time a story arc is over, the main storyline has to stop for a few episodes just so we can get to know these new people. Unlike thrillers like Death Note and Future Diary, which are constantly exciting and intense, Monster definitely requires an element of patience to get through. But personally, I still don't have a problem enjoying it because the characters they keep creating are just so good, as well as the writing. In fact, I'll give you an example of why the writing in this show is so great. One of the main characters they introduce early on is an obsessed inspector named Lungay from the German Federal Police, who's convinced that Dr. Tenma is responsible for the murders Johan's been committing. But he also has this weird tick in his hand which he describes as a typing motion, which helps him commit to memory any new information he receives on a case. But the motion he's making makes it almost look like he's getting ready to strangle someone. It adds a whole new level of uncomfortableness whenever he's on screen. And this is a detail they could have easily left out and no one would have complained. But by going the extra mile in this way, it makes the character and all the scenes with him so much more memorable. The whole show is full of great rich screenwriting like this, all these little details they add to make even the minor characters stick with you. And speaking of which, the characters are really great. Even the ones who only appear for a single episode are really memorable. For example, Johan's twin sister Anna is a great character. She's lost her memories from when she was a kid, and after getting involved in this whole mess, decides she wants to track down Johan as well. She has a lot of time and character development dedicated to her, and all of it's great. There's a whole host of other great characters in this show, and I couldn't list them all even if I wanted to. But a couple noteworthy ones include Dr. Tenma's ex-fiancée named Ava, a complete emotional wreck who both loves and despises Dr. Tenma at the same time. She's one of those emotionally complicated characters where you're never sure exactly how to feel about her. Half the time you want to punch her, the other half you feel really sorry for her. She'll lie and do horrible things for the sake of petty revenge, but at the same time you can see the tragedy that put her in this situation. I really like characters like this that challenge the standard good guy versus bad guy archetypes you see in so many other stories. There's even a kid character who's done pretty well. As soon as you hear that there's going to be a kid sidekick in this show, it sounds like a horrible idea. But the kid, named Dieter, is actually really likable, with an appropriately dark backstory that fits the tone of the show. Although there is the issue that after the first couple episodes where he's introduced, he doesn't really do anything. In fact, he's pretty much a totally pointless character after they finish his brief story arc. But at the same time, he doesn't really get in the way of the story, so I don't mind all that much. If I had to nitpick one thing about Monster I didn't like, it would probably be that once you get up to around the 50 to 60 episode mark, the sheer amount of detail in the story starts to weigh it down a bit. Like I said, it's a really big and complicated story, and every time they begin a new story arc, they add in a ton of new characters and situations. And especially toward the end of the show, there's a lot of stuff to keep track of. I often found myself having to mentally backtrack a bit to remind myself exactly what the characters were trying to do and what was going on. But aside from that, and it really is a nitpick, Monster is a fantastic psychological thriller anime, probably one of the best. The characters are great, the story is great, the writing is great, the villain is great, everything about it is just done incredibly well. It's a show that I feel often slips under the radar compared to most other mainstream anime. Don't get me wrong, it's got a very devoted fanbase. But it's not a household name the way shows like Naruto and Death Note are. And that's a shame because it really deserves to be. And maybe the reason is that it is so different from what people think of when they think of most anime. It's not a fantasy, it doesn't have any big supernatural action scenes. It's just a really great suspenseful thriller. And what the hell's wrong with that? If you haven't seen it, check it out. It's definitely worth your time. This is ShadowACS, and I'll see you next time.